Welcome to another mini tutorial. This time around we have this lovely bookshelf blueprint and we will have an earthquake going. Now what will happen is that the earthquake will affect the bookshelf and the books in it, and the books will fall out. Now when the books hit the ground, they should play an impact sound. But because the ground shakes, we don't want the audio file to be played over and over and over and over again. So to prevent all of that, I made this bookshelf blueprint. Now, this is the blueprint itself. It has a dummy scene component, which makes it easier to scale, to rotate and to position the subcomponents, all of them. And under them we have a book mesh, which has a simple collision. And I just changed two things here. The first thing is I enabled simulate physics, so gravity will affect and the physics engine will affect the book. And I changed this here. I added a tag called falling object. This is very important. So the next thing is the bookshelf mesh, the bookshelf itself, and it just has simulate physics checked too. Nothing more. It has no component tags or whatsoever. Then I have two static meshes that just duplicates of the book mesh, and they have exactly the same settings. Then I have the box overlap, where I didn't change exactly a lot of things. I just have the collision preset on overlap all dynamic. So only dynamic objects or movable objects will be able to influence or be registered in this collision box. The last thing I have here is the book drop. It's just an audio file. And I changed one thing, I disabled the auto activate checkbox, because we don't want to play the sound when the level begins. This is the event graph from the bookshelf blueprint. We have several nodes here, and the first one is on component begin overlap. This node triggers when something with a collision collides with the box here, or overlaps the box. Then it will fire off the branch node, which checks if a condition is true or not. And the condition I choose what component has tag. It searches for a component which has a tag, or if a component has a tag falling object. And if it is true, it will fire off the do once node. The do once node only triggers a chain of events once, and it doesn't reset itself. After this is completed, it will play the sound, and this here is just a reference to the audio, which I have here. And after the play node comes the set node. It takes the input from the other component, so it has the instance of the colliding object, and will disable generate overlap events. So we don't get this. So the overlap box here doesn't register it anymore. So we don't get these multiple sounds if they maybe drop out of the collision box and drop in again. And this, after this, the output execution here, or the output pin, will then reset the do once node. So the other objects, like other books, can play the sound without problems. Now we will try this. Let's see. Ah, we'll make another test. Okay, one. It works. I hope I could help, and I wish you a good day. Bye.